has. We've come to witness the Church of Christ United of Worship Chorale live in concert tonight here at the Church of Christ in Jackson Street. But we truly believe that everybody is somebody and Jesus is Lord of us all. We're very glad to have with us Brother Gerald McLean. He is from the Boulder Crest Church of Christ in Atlanta, Georgia. Brother McLean has brought a number of things with us. We have some keys right here that's been found. I'll keep them on me. You can find me. But it looks like it's a car key, a nice car. More than happy to carry this with me. Okay, I know what belongs to me. Brother McLean, we're going to turn everything over to you. We are especially grateful for this beautiful group. I want you to know that we fed this group, and those who did so said that this was one of the nicest groups of persons that had been here at the Church of Christ in Jackson Street. And we certainly appreciate the very kind of We're very glad to have you. May God bless you, and may God keep you. Keep them in prayer as they travel to and fro. They come from around the United States of America.
Next up is took a chance on doing this like this. I put together those CDs that you all got, and I put the music on those CDs that you've been listening to for months. I put the original on there so I can put the parts on it. So I rely on your ability to listen for your part and come here with your part. Most of you may have learned the melody, and now I have to fix it. So I have to hear what you've heard, because everybody hears something different. So I can hear what you've heard as we move along and work on these. I traveled to some states, Michigan, my home state. I rehearsed with them quite often. Of course, I'm in Georgia. I rehearsed with them quite often. Went to Alabama once to do their orientation, dropped off CDs, and prayed that they listened and learned. And Tennessee, I came here when I was building up on this. So I've been here, in Tennessee as well. So that's been the process. You registered, I sent you a CD, and you listened to it, and now you're here. So we're going to see what this is going to sound like. Now, is their first year. This is some first year, but then it's in their second year. Who is in their first year here? Who is this the first time? Stand up. On this project as freshmen. You are freshmen to me. That's a five-year program.
That's right.
So hopefully you'll graduate and go into graduate in the fifth year. Or some of y'all may drop out of school, but I don't know. But you're freshmen, so welcome to freshmen. So I'm going to assume that the rest of you are sophomores. Okay, have a sit down, which would take us to 2019. The Church of Christ United in Songs, Hymns, and Spiritual Songs from Colossians 3, 15, 17, which can be found in the programs that you all don't have, but I believe they have. Okay? So now, let me get a sense of what this is going to sound like so I will know where to start molding the sound. Let's sing this.
Take you back to Friday, July 1st. The chorale is now making preparations to sing at Lipscomb University. They have assembled in the Allen Arena. This is where the final day of the three-day summer celebration comes to an end.
Well, we had a long day coming up today. Tonight, we're at Lipscomb University. That is a big arena. Most you're accustomed to singing in a basketball arena like that. At Lipscomb University or anywhere else. So it's going to be a challenge for you all in that arena. But I know you'll come through, and we're going to start rehearsing for that as well as what we're going to do Saturday, July 2nd. So we're going to move right into that. So let's warm up on You Are the Most High. You Are the Most High. Okay, let's warm up on that. You know how we did it? Ready? Move. Here we go.
have an evening of song and fellowship. Since this is the 4th of July weekend, the chorale topped the evening off with a wonderful fireworks display on campus. What a better way to end a long, joyous day. Ooh. The chorale has assembled now, July 2nd, at the Jackson Street, at the Church of Christ at Jackson Street in the Fellowship Hall. The director, through much prayer and supplication, is giving his final prep talk, an encouraging message to the chorale.
Well, choir, this is it. This is what we have been working on for the past year. Those of you who were able to fit this project into your schedule and make what sacrifices you have made to come here to Nashville at my request. I want to just say thank you to all from the bottom of my heart. And I hope that you have enjoyed this journey as much as I have. We have met new friends, Christian friends from all the states. And this is my first time here at the Church of Christ at Jackson Street. Some of you from Jackson Street sang with us last year, with us in Atlanta, and we were glad that you were here. You are here tonight, and I can't leave. I will acknowledge the leadership here at the end of this program. But before we take the stage, I want you to do one more musical thing for me. I want you to demonstrate just how brilliant, and I use that term loosely, you are at learning music without the benefit of reading notes or on sheet music. Some of you can't read. You mimic what I teach you very well and have a solid ear for music. So I am going to give you a new phrase to sing. The lyrics are, who will go? Will you go? I will go. Easy, right? So repeat after me. Who will go?
Who will go?
Will you go?
Will you go?
I will go.
I will go.
One more time. Who will go?
Who will go?
Will you go?
Will you go?
I will go.
I will go.
The biblical reference of this song can be found in Matthew 9:36-38. I'm supposed to read from the Bible, but I don't have one in front of me. So I will improvise, give you an idea. The lyrics are, as Jesus is talking in Matthew, the laborers are few, the harvest is ripe, the fields are empty. Who will go? So that's what he's asking. Who will go? And as he was saying that, and there's more to the lyrics, just imagine that he's standing there next to me, asking me, who will go? Will you go? You will acknowledge him and say, I will. And it goes like this. This is how I'm going to do it. I give you the notes that I need starting with Sopranos. And Sopranos, the way I imagine you, because of your voices, you are my angels. You may not act like it most of the time, but you're my angels. Okay? That's how I categorized you. My outsoles, I categorize you as sassy, don't take no stuff, that kind of thing. Okay? That's my outsoles. Tenors, y'all are just cool and laid back. With that smooth sound. Contraltos for the ladies, tenors, men, y'all just cool. And of course, bass. The voice of God himself. So, you have not heard this before, because I didn't want you to cheat. So you must demonstrate how brilliant you are. Please, okay? Please. Okay? So, here it goes. Here it goes. Okay, now I gotta go back. Do not sing any notes, and that goes for all of you, until I give it to you. Because if you sing something ridiculous, that's when I'm just being whack. Okay? So don't sing anything until I give it to you. Understood? Yes?
Yes.
All right. Here we go. Now, I don't like singing in your tone, but I'm gonna go up there one time, okay?
Who will go?
Now I'm going in my voice. Who will go?